Welcome back to West Texas View.
Just before the break, we were talking with Bill about campfire in general, and he was telling about the kinds of people they hire to have jurisdiction over these after-school programs. And particularly, he likes college students that are majoring in education. And this gives them a great experience on the job training kind of thing. Plus, a lot of substitute teachers or retired teachers that are coming back. And so if you are someone that just loves children and you are looking for part-time work,
absolutely,
this would be a great thing for you to call the number that's rolling across your screen that gives his information and talk to him about a job. He was telling me at the break that there were several other schools they could have opened after-school programs in if they had had trained employees to take care of them. So this is a good employment opportunity.
Absolutely.
And now I want us to talk about, you have one fundraiser a year.
That's correct.
And that one fundraiser helps fund everything for your whole year. But you also get funding from other sources?
Absolutely. There's probably four major sources of income that we get. And one is the fees for our after-school and summer programs.
Is very low.
Yeah, it was very low, and it's also based on family income.
Uh-huh.
So if you have a child that's coming from a background where the parents cannot afford it, then we reduce the fees, or they have no fees at all to come to our programs.
Or you have a family that has several children.
Absolutely, then we have reduced fees for each one of those children.
Yeah.
So they can afford to do it, because it can be very expensive if you have four or five children.
That's right.
So that's one of our main sources. The other one, we're part of the United Way, both of Midland and Odessa. We get funding from them to help out. We also get grants and from foundations that are here locally in town, Abel Hanger Foundation, the Moore Foundation, and other, Faskin, are major foundations that help us raise money for our budget.
Mm-hmm.
And then our what we call our family concert that we do every year. Mm-hmm. And our board is the one, we have 16 board members, they're all volunteers, that help raise about $70,000 that we need to operate it, to provide to offer those programs and activities at a low rate that everyone can afford.
And you are in new offices out at shared spaces.
Midland Shared
As a matter of fact, Abel Hanger
helped get that started.
Provided, yes. Mm-hmm. And so you are recognized as one of the top nonprofit agencies by virtue of that you were invited to come and be a part of the shared spaces, which gives you a lot of advantages.
Oh, absolutely. It's a wonderful place to have an office, an office out of, and it allows people to come to us and get part of our program that we would not be able to do if we're not part of the shared
And you know, we would be amiss if we didn't say that it's an opportunity for nonprofits to be more effective in using their funds.
Absolutely.
Because you're sharing boardrooms, you're sharing printing space, you're sharing equipment, and a lot of things that allows you to reduce your normal budget. And so that makes you use your money that you're raising from other sources directly for these children.
Absolutely.
That you're using. So let's talk about some of the fundraisers you've had in the past, and then that brings us to the one you're going to have this year.
Yeah, they've done all kinds of things in campfire in the past, from golf tournaments to clay shoots to all those types of things. But one of the last 6 years, we've done our family concert. And five out of those 6 years, we've brought in the group that we've talked about, Trout Fishing in America, as the main musical group that we bring in to provide our concert, plus the workshop and the concert we do for children on the Monday after the concert.
Uh-huh. And before we talk about Trout Fishing in America, I want us to say that they're coming to do the family concert, which will be the major fundraiser.
Right.
But they're also giving two other concerts just for children as part of the package.
Absolutely.
And one of them, this is so exciting to me, one of them, tell about the songwriting.
Right. On Sunday's the concert. On the Monday the 12th, January the 12th, we'll be at Carver School. It's a magnet school in Carver Center School in Midland. And 40 children there are selected by the school that are fourth grade and above will come and we'll have a songwriting workshop. The Trout Fishing and American, both Keith and Ezra, are the two band members, and they come with the children and write a song. Believe it or not, in an hour, they come up with the lyrics.
The kids write the lyrics.
Absolutely, with the help of Keith and Ezra. Uh-huh. They write the lyrics, uh-huh. They sing the song at the end of it after they've done it, and then they record that and send that back to the school so the school can play it for everyone that wants to hear it.
Uh-huh.
And it's really a fun experience. The kids enjoy it. They laugh. They come up with all of the ideas. They vote on which ideas that they want to have the song for. They vote on the lyrics. They help in it. It's a really a great learning experience. And the artists are trying to encourage them that you can write songs. You can do this. Mm-hmm. This is something you can actually learn how to do and enjoy doing.
And the imagination and creativity that they spark Absolutely. Is just amazing.
It's amazing to me because I don't have that creativity. Uh-huh. But I see that coming out of the children. I think it's a great mm-hmm. experience. And hopefully it'll get them to think about, you know, being involved more in music, whether it's singing or it's musical instruments, some way in band or something like that in their life. Because uh-huh. that has a great quality in your life when you have those things
yeah.
involved.
But tell the song that they've written in the past called My Hair Had a Party.
My Hair Had a Party Last Night. That's one of the songs that's one of their famous songs that Trout Fishing did. And they talked to the kids about it. Well, what if we would have named a song, you know, My Hair Got Messed Up Last Night? And the kids go, no, that doesn't sound as good. So he said, so words make a big difference. So when you say, my hair had a party, what does that make you think about? Wow, it might have been dancing or it might have been doing this or that. And so they talk about words, the power of words that you mm-hmm. use and descriptive language that make the mind think. And so that's great for young kids. Mm-hmm. I mean, ages, you know, fourth grade, fifth grade, sixth grade kids.
And the pride they have when they go away from that 1 hour workshop and say, oh my goodness, I wrote a song. I
absolutely helped to write a song, absolutely. And the trout fishing is actually used in the past some of the ideas that came from these workshops to write songs that they now put on their albums that they have.
Yeah, and one other thing, they're going to also have a concert that same day at Milam Elementary School
in Odessa. Absolutely. Uh-huh. We're gonna in the after the morning is the workshop, and in the afternoon we're going to do at 1:30 at Milam Elementary in Odessa, which is a magnet school, fine arts school. We're gonna have a 1 hour concert.
Yeah. Okay. We're gonna come back and complete this conversation in just a minute and tell you more about trout fishing in America.
Stay tuned. West Texas View will be right back.